So, let's talk about the Innovation Awards. This year, instead of having an animated in-game version of the Innovation Awards, Roblox decided to have an in-person version. Every year, Roblox has something called RDC, the Roblox Developer Conference. Certain people are invited to the conference in which the CEO of Roblox, David Bazooka, I mean, Bazooki, and other important people over at Roblox discuss new features coming to the platform. This year, the Innovation Awards, previously known as the Bloxy Awards, was at RDC. It was recorded on a live stream for all of us to watch, now displayed on screen. And let's just say that not everything went as ideal as possible. As usual, this had a lot of backlash with, unfortunately, everything Roblox does. But one thing we could all agree on was that Dancing David Bazooki was not a disappointment. Just look at those dance moves, bro. By the way, if you'd like to watch the Innovation Awards, but just because, maybe you don't want to watch the premiere, maybe you want to help a fellow friend out. I for some reason recorded the whole thing and it's on my channel. I don't know why. But this year the Innovation Awards was hosted by J Party, as you can see here on screen. Another well-known important person over at Roblox. I'm sure you're not here to hear me rant about all the little details. So let's get to the issues the Innovation Awards faced and all the backlash, because as we know by now, drama is way more relevant. Not relevant, but that's the type of content people prefer to watch. So without further ado, I'm just gonna stop ranting and being annoying, and I'm going to look. I don't usually this. I'm reading off of a script. I don't usually do this. This isn't in my nature. I am usually chaotic in my videos. So, if it's your first time here, I am very sorry for what you have to experience. But first of all, for some reason, I don't know why, it makes no sense at all. Four awards were left out. And we're only tweeted out once the event ended. No one really knows why, because supposedly the event was supposed to go on for 2 more hours than it actually lasted. Kreecraft said that. I don't know how much I can trust that, but I mean, we can trust Kreecraft, right? There's also a situation with the Piggy community and the TDS community, but I don't want to get too detailed on that because I'm not 100% sure about all the details involved in it, and I don't want to go that far. You can go and, find out about it if you want yourself. It's a big thing right now on Twitter. If you have that. Okay. On a more positive note, though, I mean, Roblox is really, the platform is really progressing. Look how cool this is. Interval? I should play the realistic games like that. My computer would probably explode. But look at that. That's so cool, isn't it? Roblox is really getting more realistic. And it's still not losing the blocky style that it was made for, and that we still all love. I know we're not the biggest supporters of Arthro, but Roblox is really taking a new shape, and I feel like we shouldn't all be completely against it. Props to all developers. This is amazing. Even if you're making a blocky game, as we know, everyone appreciates you. The developers of Roblox are what make up Roblox. I've gotta say it. Something not too amazing, though, was PGHL's situation. Not the best thing ever. He was supposed to be part of the awards, but sadly not. Didn't happen. Roblox completely ignored his existence, and some are saying cut him out of the awards. He himself is very calm and not encouraging it at all, so seriously, props to him. Not just his fans, but the whole Piggy community is infuriated about what happened. So angry about how PGHL completely lost his spotlight and what he worked for. The Innovation Awards has kind of been all over the place. So much for innovation. The Builderman Award of Excellence. We're really not exactly to the end of the video, but I thought I might just stick this in here because I thought it was like a, I don't know. I'm not used to reading off of a script like this. Decided by Builderman himself, as it is every year, the award was given to Starving Artist. Starving Artist is a part of the genre of making Robux games. Most of you have heard of the Roblox game Please Donate. Please Donate was made by a 15-year-old developer, Hazem. Many are mad that the award was given to starving artists and Hazem wasn't even mentioned. Many also don't have a problem with it, including Hazem himself. He is very chill about it and says he's not mad. He's friends with the developers of starving artists and has no problems with that at all. Twitter is filled with people's thoughts on the Innovation Awards. You can go and hunt down some replies yourself. But I'll just leave you with a couple of lasting notes. Here's Creek's tweet, a well-known YouTuber. You probably all know who he is. Congrats to the winners of the Innovation Awards. Overall, a very nice weekend for Roblox developers and creators looking forward to the future. Hopefully, there won't be as many disasters. And here's also a poll that a very well-known Twitter, I guess, Roblox Twitter news source put out, RTC. It's very mixed, the feelings about the Innovation Awards. Would you guys like the awards to be at RTC again, or an animated award in a Roblox game? I personally like the animated awards, which I guess they were called the Bloxies. I like them more. This was, in this situation, it was good if you were there watching the Innovation Awards in person, but just watching it from the premiere seemed kind of boring. Thank you for watching, though, and I will see you guys all in the next video. Make sure to comment down below your thoughts, and I hope this wasn't too boring, because all I did was read off a script.
They'll be my treasures forever. When I can't hold you tight, I'll see the Stockholm lights.